bottom left corner. When you look at the chat window. Wait. It's hard to look at your own. Yeah, that's the wrong way, right? So look at that way. Entertaining myself. Yay. Well, welcome to the stream. Welcome to the YouTube archive as well, people on YouTube. Today, I'm going to be making some sky tiles. So, last night I finished up the optimizations to, finished up fixing some bugs related to all these optimizations I've made this week. So, overall, the game is incredibly more efficient. It used to take about 8 seconds or so per 10 seconds. So, 80% of the time it was spent in the game engine. Alex Pita! Hello! Buongiorno! Was that close? QLav! What's up, QLav? I was just saying, you guys, that the game is used to take... Let's see. Actually, let's confirm this. Let's confirm how much faster the game is now. This little bit here. What's up? Is it Michi? Michael? Hi. Hello. Welcome to the stream. I'm just confirming how much faster the game is now. And then I'm going to make some sky tiles. So this is actually going to... We're going to have some tiles that will actually fall away from the floor. That's going to be cool. And also, it'll reveal whatever is beneath it. Like... sky or whatever. Hey, Big Mac Dev. Howdy. Howdy, howdy. Mike. All right. What's up, Mike? So, I was profiling this week. It started off here. And the game... Look at this. Okay, so it used to take... Over a span of 10 seconds, the game used to spend 97% of the time in the game engine. What's up, Pale Ale? Howdy. Happy Sunday to you, too. And now, after all these optimizations... Where's the one? Is this the latest one? Anyways, the game now takes about 2 seconds. So, overall, the game engine... Ekloff, what's up? We're just looking at the kind of what happened this week, and now I'm gonna get artistic today. So today's gonna be an art day, yay! So the game used to take 9,700 milliseconds per 10 seconds, and now it takes like 2,200 milliseconds. That's like 4,400% faster. So the game is like just way more efficient. That's pretty stoked. I'm pretty stoked about that. Ah, what's going on with Twitch, man? Oh no. Lost your voice. Christy. What's up, Art Games? Oh no, man. Can you refresh? Alessandro? Refresh. There you go. All right. Oh, it's iPad? Oh. Freaking iPads. So today I'm going to make it some sky tiles. So some of these tiles, like on the levels, will be... See, like, you'll be able to see the sky or the ground or whatever it is there beneath it. You'll be able to see beneath these tiles. So let's find an area like this one, for example. I'll get it so these pillars here are all sky. What's up, Blue Wolf? Welcome to the stream. Hello. Nice to meet you. Alright, so I'll start with area patterns. And I'm just going to make everything that was water or pillars turn into sky. Here it is. Pattern level random. Tile equals K-tile rock. This is it. Boom. K-tile sky. Let's see if that worked. So what this should do is if it works, it'll just show blackness for these tiles instead of pillars. And then I'll work on getting them so you can see the edges of the other tiles through them. Okay, so that didn't work. Why didn't that work? Water isthmus, four dots, diagonal lines, boss. Maybe I don't have the right. Oh, okay. So it's using different tiles down here. Which one of these patterns is the one that's running in the current level? Oh, I guess it's connector pattern. Okay. So instead of rock in the connector pattern, we'll use sky. And hopefully that should show some just blackness instead of those pillars. And then I'll work on the edges. All right, cool. So we got something, but what the heck is it showing? Oh, it is showing the edge tile. So I drew an edge tile already for these. Wow, crazy. So I'm going to turn off these edge tiles first. Oh, cool. Wait a minute. Unity playing nice with C++? What do you mean? Unity can use C++ now? What's up, Felix? Howdy. Howdy, howdy, howdy. Area creation. There's this part where it creates... rock tiles. Or sky tiles. Maybe it's a sky tile. No, it's not sky tile. Oh, like a plugin? Okay. Wow, that sounds challenging. Good on ya. It might actually be where it creates the ground. So create, I think it's create level ground. What the heck is the name of this function? There, tiles one ground. Now, is this the place? Yeah, here it is, vertical. Boom, this is where it creates this vertical tile. So this should make it so it's black, and then I'll draw some better edges because those were crazy weird because they're using a white sky. There we go. So that's kind of what I was imagining. We've got some sky basically set up right here. Now I just got to make it so these are thicker. All right, so this is the file, level one vertical, and I'll get that opened up. Yes, it's been about, geez, it's been so long since I used my art pen. Hello, old friend. All right, so level one vertical. Level one vertical zero. Yeah, this is kind of weird. So we'll turn all these to be black instead of white. Invert. Well, I guess we could start with that and see how it looks. Hey, I can't remember who recommended the Rival Sons for me to check out. The Rival Sons, they're this awesome band. But whoever mentioned that a couple days ago, thank you so much. The Rival Sons are awesome. What's up, Doc? Howdy, Doc. Just making some, I'm finally doing some art again. I'm making some edges for these level tiles. I'm very excited to do it. Okay, so now I can go back and uncomment these. All right. So these are all a bit too big. It's using the really tall one. Why is it using the really tall one all the time? Let's figure that out. I get vertical frame. Okay, because it's using this get vertical frame function. So the get vertical frame function. Is it just me or does it seem like the chat's slower today? It's weird. Get vertical frame. Let's just change this to be using get, like use the first frame. See how this looks at zero only. That's kind of what I was imagining. So there, the bug we're seeing here with that, with the enemy is that he started for it somehow on those rocks. I don't know why it would do that. This guy's in a weird position too. Like, it looks like I need to work on that math. For where it places enemies at first. Oh no! So I got locked in this room and that enemy got thrown behind the wall. Alright. That was weird. Okay, so how can I improve the visuals right there? Let's put the player here in this room. 3, 4, 2, I think is 421. Yeah, here's the room. All right. Let's try with a sky with some clouds in the sky beneath it. I think I do that in the dungeon generator, where it's K ground style, ground tiles one. I thought there was a background style. I think there is a background style I'm looking for. KBG. No, not. Oh, there it is. K background. K background. There it is. Alright, so I'm turning the background into be some sky. Hello! What's up, Letter Thief? How you doing today? Whoa, weird. So, that's super bright. It's not really jiving with this whole level style here. Yeah. This one I just ended up starting on time. But yeah, it is earlier than usual, because usually I'm like an hour late. So yeah, I'm definitely going to try and do this a lot more. Yeah, I'm good, man. I'm really good. I'm really happy. So I did the math, and the game is actually 4,400% faster than it was a week ago. So over the course of 10 seconds, the game used to take 9,700 milliseconds to do all of its math, update its sprites and everything. Now the game only takes 2 seconds. So it's just way the heck faster, way more efficient, and doesn't run my fan on my laptop anymore. No, that's 9,000 is bad. 2,000 is way better as far as how much time the game uses of your CPU and your, yeah. Yeah, totally. It's so awesome. And so now I'm working on some art, finally. And I'm working on this thing right here where there's going to be sky tiles so you can see through. So I just tried it with this sort of bright sky, and it looks way too bright. So I gotta come up with a darker sky. But I like the fact that it's animated, so I want to do some kind of animation back here, but a lot darker. Oh, here's a Dragon Ball Z joke. Dang, I wish I would have caught that one. It's hot in here. It's hot in here today. Man, I'm really gonna be thirsty. I guess we could do a different kind of background sky. Well, yeah, I think that's probably what to do here, a different background sky. Hey, what's up, professional novice? Howdy. Oh.
Say about his power level? It's over 9,000! What the?
Oh, man. Dude, this is like the epitome of anime. I love it. I haven't seen this episode. That's cool. It's over 9,000! Yeah. Working on some sky here. Background sky. It's over 9,000. Cool. I'm glad I get this joke now. All right. So here's the thing. We'll use sky 1 and 2. Sky 1 will be black-ish. Sky 2 will be that light color that I was using there. Where did I? Man, I'm out of it today. Here we go. I gotta create another background sky function. Somebody. Hey, what's up, Vlad? Yeah, enuming it up. Enum. Oi. Hey, Ekloff, have you heard the band called The Rival Sons? Was it you that recommended The Rival Sons? No, it was somebody else yesterday, or the day before. But Ekloff, I think you'd like The Rival Sons, too. I checked them out, I'm like, whoa, I can't believe I've never heard The Rival Sons before. Yeah, going great, Vlad. super great. I'm working on some art today. Finally got done with this whole week of code. So many improvements. The game's like, the game is about 4,400% faster than it was a week ago. So I'm just like, I'm stoked about that. And now I'm like, yay, I get to make art again. Yeah, you should check them out, man. Totally, you'd dig them. I think you'd dig them. Oh yeah, in the dungeon generator. Okay, we already did that one. Where? Okay, BG style. Sky one. Now we gotta update area. Total lines of code. Let's see. Good call. It's probably increased a tiny bit, but I can't wait to make it fall away. Yeah, it's increased a little. It's 24,700. I had it down to 24,200, but I did add a lot of comments when I added any foo. Yeah, nice. Yeah. I like them. They're pretty cool. Reminds me of, you know, who's up? I can't believe I can't think of the name of the band right now. Oh, Vlad, it makes a lot of difference. A lot of difference. Vlad, every single line of code you write is a debt. So this is a time debt. Every single line of code I write, I will one day have to go back and maintain that line of code, fix that line of code, do something else to make that line of code better. Like, so the less code you have, the better. And that's why I'm doing a lot of things to make it more data-driven, like this settings.plist and stuff like that. So as I make the game more and more data-driven, I'll be able to just take away large swaths of code that I'll never ever have to maintain again. I know, it's so much, right? This is, the game's only 30% complete at this point, too. So hopefully by the time it's 100% complete, it's like not, it's still around 25K or less, if possible. That would be nice. Yeah, totally, right? And the black keys, that's what I was thinking of, the black keys. Reminds me of the black keys, too. How can I forget the black keys? What? Here we got sky one background, we'll do sky two background. Oh, that's still a lot, 5,000. That's a lot. Sky 2, Sky 1. Yeah, I know, right? Yeah. I didn't even notice with this game. Oh, well, what do you mean? What do you mean? What do you mean about the reason people ask? So sky one background is not going to have this gradient. And what are these things? Oh, these are the lit. Okay, these are the entities that the sky goes onto. All right, 36. And I want to reduce the. Actually, let's try the opacity with them like that, without the without the gradient background. It probably is going to look a lot lighter in color. Okay, so they're still really bright, and not quite what I was thinking there. Let's make them a lot more opaque. Oh, maybe dark purple. That's a good idea. Let's try that. Let's try a dark gradient. So I'm going from black. Let's do this vector. And then color HSV, what is this, saturation value? Let's turn the value way down. And then turn the opacity on all these clouds like way, way down. Count times 21. Took this to 16 and this to like 8 max. What part of it's complex to you? I'd love to make it more simple myself. Simplicity is beautiful. Oh, Vlad. Oh, I totally get you what you mean now. Yeah. Yeah. In general, that can kind of be true. Like, for example, Grand Theft Auto has like millions of lines of code, but not necessarily. Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah, I got you. Yeah. So yeah, my personal view on it is the less lines of code, the better. And okay, so okay, that looks weird now with the gradient upside down. Let's try to put the gradient back to how it was. All right. What's up, Defend? Okay, so the clouds are still layering because there's so many of them layered together. They're becoming really bright by the time they're done there. Oh, the vector functions. Right, right. What language do you usually code in? Yeah, Baka Orange. What's up, Baka Orange? Hey. Welcome to stream. Yeah, that's Jonathan Blow, right? What's his name? Huh. Interesting. Yes, it does. It does. It does look weird with the shadows. That's why I wanted to make it more black. I wonder if there's a simple way I can improve the shadows so they don't render. On the sky. Oh man, that'd be tricky with this 2D engine. Oh, okay. C and Objective-C. Gotcha. Yeah, I agree. It's harder to keep it minimal, but it's more rewarding because then you just have less to maintain. So, this is, I'm going to set this opacity way down this time. I guess I could mask those parts. That's how I'm doing the reflection. Oh yeah, I guess I could do that. Okay, you know what? That's an excellent idea, Lighter Thief. All the water reflections work that way. They just have a, I make a reflection mask at first when I first load the level, and then I use that in the shader for the reflections. So I might as well do that. I'll just make a shader. Or a reflection or a mask and then pass it into the shader for the blur shader for the shadows. Good idea. In fact, I could probably do that right now if I want. I'll start with making these backgrounds even better because, for example, the top, I'd like to see some more clouds up there. Oh, yeah, I've heard this a couple times before. Yeah. I've heard it also about his friend that makes the other game too. Handmade Hero. Mike, this is basically it's my own game engine on top of Cocos 2DX. So the technologies I'm using Cocos 2DX for the game engine. I'm using Rapid Game to pre-build it. And I'm using Entity Foo, which is an entity component system I wrote for this game, and then I released on GitHub. So Entity Foo is right here. Here's a link to it. If you want it, if you want to check it out, here's a link. Yeah, I don't know who he is. I've never watched his stream. I've only heard things about it. Oh, okay. I should give those guys a watch sometime. See what they do. They're probably doing some things right, you know? Some things right, some things righter. Why step? Here. Okay, so I'll set these clouds way higher. See if we can get some more clouds in this whole mix. Ah. Yo! Unreal, Mr. Unreal, you changed your name again. What's up, man? Yeah, thank you, man. Thank you so much. Yeah, the whole Kickstarter green light phase was so rewarding and awesome. Nice, you had exams? How'd it go? How'd it go? It's going so great here. So this is the first week of development after the Kickstarter, and this whole week I've just been doing code optimization. So the game is actually 4,400% faster than it was a week ago. It's just way more efficient in its usage of time. So, okay. That's what I've heard too. I've heard this about his programming language he's writing and stuff. Don't know. I can't really provide any kind of opinion on the matter because I really haven't seen his live streams or his talks. Okay, so this time the clouds are like way up higher and they need more step between them. So we'll add some more step. Still not sure if I'm even into the whole concept here of clouds being in this background or not. I mean, this is kind of in the sky, but I'm thinking about possibly changing some of the levels and making them underneath the ground instead of in the sky. Oh, I think I see what's going on. This last layer of clouds. Ah. 98%? Whoa, dude. Good job. Oh, wow. Nice. What Google office are you going to be working at? Because I'm here in the Bay Area. I'm in Oakland. Oakland. Which is a pretty cool place. What's up, Crashnell? Yeah, totally, right? Adding some parallax in a top down is kind of an interesting thing. But I'm trying to get the look to be just right here. So, yeah, a few rooms, right? Oh, London, Google London. Nice. Wow. I'm kind of jealous. I think London, I've only been to it for like 8 hours or something like that, but it seems like a magical place. Magical in a London-y kind of way. That's really accurate of me to say, right? London rocks. When I think of London, I think of Jimi Hendrix and him going there and becoming successful and getting all his crazy clothes and stuff. So that's why I think of London as a magical place. So, see, now we're starting to get a little bit more of the right feel for these backgrounds here. Yeah. Yeah, it's expensive. Oh, professional novice, you should talk to there's two guys here on the stream, Alex Pita and Mars of Power, and both those guys are from Italy, and maybe they can give you some tips. Oh, where do you live? I know what you mean though. I live here in the Bay Area. And San Francisco is hella expensive. Oh, dark clouds with maybe some lightning. Good idea. Oh, interesting. I'll try that right now. Good thought, lighter thief. Oh, Slovakia. There's a couple of you guys on here from Slovakia. Whoa. Man, I didn't know Scotland was that expensive. Yeah. Let's try flipping them all. Sprite set flipped Y. True. True. Yeah. Something like fog, right. Professional novice, here it is. Alex Pita. Alex Pita, professional novice, is curious about Italy, about visiting. Okay, so this will flip them over. But it. Oh, right. Okay. That does make sense. If you're up in the sky, in this like sky world type thing. But the top would need some work here. Wow, they charge weekly? Whoa. Maybe I'll do the opposites. Yeah, the room is above the clouds. But you could think of it as in the clouds. I think that's what Lighter Thief was saying. I kind of do like it better, I guess. Yeah, I guess that does make sense, right? Why is it not doing? I think I gotta either get it higher. Let's try it a little higher. Oh, and I want to try a different color. Let's do the color. Get this hue. Buongiorno. Yeah, possibly, yeah. Possibly faster or slower? Totally. This one was based on this other screen I had developed, which this speed worked good for it, but probably not for. This is the hue. Okay, this is just float hue. So we want to do age. This is the hue, the value. 0. And h dot h plus equals, no, equals f mod f h dot h plus 0.618. So what I'm doing here is I'm adding the phi ratio to the hue, and basically offsetting the hue by something which will look nice with it. So I'm using the phi ratio to create a complementary color. We mod that by 1.0, and then C equals H.2 RGB. Nice. Okay, so let's see that. That's going to be a different hue. Let's hope it works with this, complements it well. And then I'll work on getting these. Whoa, that's kind of weird. Sort of this muddy brown. I wonder what's going on with this line I'm seeing right here. Right? Oh, interesting idea. Huh. Cool. I like that. I guess the easiest way to do that would be to make it. I could do a little function right here, which just every once in a while it makes this the background super bright. Super duper bright, 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 super bright. Tobor Prime, what's up, Tobor Prime? Hey, who is it that recommended yesterday to check out Tobor Prime? I went and I checked out Tobor Prime. And look at this. Thanks, Tobor Prime. Thanks for hosting. Okay, I'm going to try subtracting the phi ratio instead of adding. Yo, yo! No, I can't beatbox. That was just... No, I can't really. Poop! Poop on a stick! What's up, Black Mask? Oh, that's better. Okay, that's better using the phi ratio to subtract. Still, I got this weird like line here. I gotta work on that. What's up with this line? I want to see the floor like at a. I want to see a transparent floor for a second so I can see what the heck is going on with the rest of this. This screen. So we'll do create. Oh, it's right here in area. Create floor, create ground, tiles one ground. Let's make all of these. Like semi-transparent, set opacity, something like 64. So this is gonna temporarily make all the tiles in the room transparent so I can see what the heck is going on with the sky. Thanks, Tobor. Thank you. Yeah, my day's going great. Thanks for asking, Black Mask. Okay, so there. It's all weird and transparent now, but at least I can see that what's up with these clouds. So these clouds were not designed for this. So maybe I'll redesign the clouds. Uh-huh. Interesting. Cool idea. Tobor, this is, yeah, I'm working with Coco3DX. That's the game engine. Yeah, totally. I agree. Lighter Thief. So I was just subtracting the phi ratio instead of adding. Let's make some clouds that are like more poofy on both sides. So... where the heck were those clouds? Sprite, I think they're in level. Yeah, it's pretty nice, right? Xcode's pretty cool. Sublime Text is also really neat. I guess I put it here in backgrounds. Cryo? Was it cryo or something? There it is, cryo 1. Yeah, here it is. Okay, this scene, these clouds. So I gotta turn off a lot of stuff to draw these clouds a little bit better. But that'll be good to have that done. Vim, for sure. Welcome to the stream, Jexis. Man, I got respect for anybody that uses Vim. That's awesome. I think I should try and learn it because I've had all these like issues, like tendonitis and stuff in my wrist. And Vim, you don't have to leave the home row. So it's probably due to that, this bullshit using Xcode and Nano and all these other things that don't have very good. Also, the keyboard I have is just horrible. I know. Me too, Professional Novice. I never liked Vim, but now I'm starting to respect it. If you don't have to leave, if your hands never have to leave the home row, that they designed something right. Right now we got some clouds to play with. Or just learn Dvorak. There you go. Yeah. Visual Studio, Master Race. Welcome to stream, Dwelu. Is Happy Towel Day? Is it really Towel Day? Like towel, like 42 towel, like, or towel, like towel in general. Oh. Yeah, is this use Perlin noise? Yeah, I saw this one. Probably should do something like this. Animate some really cool clouds. Cool. Let me actually. Yeah, I probably should do something really awesome like this rather than just drawing some clouds right here. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna switch back to the clouds being the other way around and just call that good for now because I probably will do something where I just animate some clouds with Perlin noise or something. And that'll just look super sick. Oh wow, VS Vim extension. Nice. That's what I was thinking, Douglas Adams. Yeah. That kind of towel day. I'm glad I got the reference. Yay. I finally got something. What's up, Safari? Why are you being all weird? Oh. Don't panic. Nice. I never knew there was towel day. God rest his soul. Yes, right. I know. Yep. And for months, this has been happening, professional novice. This is like, I'm pretty clueless. Sometimes I'm like just in my own little cave here, and you guys are bringing me out, teaching me about towel day and other stuff. Yeah, where's my towel? Dude, I gotta get a towel. Hold on. Oh, there's a towel right here. All right, dude, I got a towel now. I'm ready to go. It's towel day. Towel day, towel day. Woo! It's towel day once again, everybody. Aren't you excited? We've come back to towel day. We arrived. Sky one, sky two. Yeah, so I'm just gonna flip these over back how they were and not worry too much about this because I think I'm gonna do some animated Perlin noise instead. You did? What? Cool, Doc. He's my favorite character too. Tau hype. Boom. Right now I gotta remember where the hell I put these the first time. Okay. This was working when it was like, well, let's start with just flipping them back over. I was actually imagining more of a black. Just black. Maybe I should just do black instead. Or the gradient. Maybe just the gradient. All right, so this needs to be a little lower and a little less step. Yeah, I only have one monitor. I don't know how I do it. I just do. I would love to have two monitors, though. That's on my bucket list. One day, when I grow up, I want to have two monitors. Mom, can I have a second monitor for Christmas? Only if you get rid of that front tooth, Timmy. There. Okay, there we go. Good. I'm calling this good for now, and then I'll do some cool stuff later with it, animating it all live and stuff. Yeah. I know, right? I hear so many great things about it. Swanky. It's like luxury. Luxurious. Two monitors. The luxury of it all. Ah, Avino. Ooh, nice, 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 nice. Right. Oh! Right, I think that's, yeah, I wasn't saying, I think this tutorial here is actually using Simplex or something else besides Perlin, because yeah, Perlin is expensive. It's too expensive to use in a shader. Oh, it looks like he might be just using pre-computed in this tutorial here. Yeah, he's using some pre-computed noise. Ways of doing it. First world problems, right? Okay, so this is good enough. Now we've got some sky tiles, and I can go around the level and start putting sky tiles in some areas. And yeah, and then we can actually, I should do this shadow mask as well, because that would really help the look of this. Actually, that looks all right. Yeah, with a nice dark. I wonder what some of these other areas would look like. Oh, that guy's stuck behind the wall again. I don't know why that guy's getting stuck on that in the first place. Oh, probably because it calls set any valid position. Tall second monitor. Ooh, weird. Oh, there he is. Yes, let me out. Whoa, I forgot about this room. This is so great. Okay, so area patterns. Yeah, let's do a connector pattern. Right, yeah, that concert's still going. Okay, so this little bit here, I'm going to make it so it randomly chooses between sky, rocks, and water for these connector patterns. And the connector pattern is a really cool one, very interesting pattern. So, if... if that... let's just do auto R. Auto R. Yeah. Hey, thanks, Tobor. And by the way, everybody, Tobor is working on an awesome game. Tobor, send us a link to your game again. What's it? It's Tobor Prime, right? Tobor Prime. Oh no, Tobor World, was it? Tobor. I looked at it on my other browser last night. What's your... you gotta post your link, man. We gotta check out your game. Looks like intermission in a concert. Yeah. Yeah, so Tobor did a successful Kickstarter as well. And his game is coming along nice. And Tobor does all his own art, all his own code, and all his own sound as well. So that's why I'm so excited to meet him. Okay, if R is less than 128, we'll do one of these. No, we gotta divide this into thirds, 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 thirds. Oh, there it is, Planet Tobor. Am I saying that right, Tobor? Savage, the Shard of Gosen. You got your public alpha up. Wait, are you, you're greenlit, right? Yeah, greenlit. Sweet. Good job, man. Good job. Oh, that's a good, this is a good page. Let's check out your trailer and stuff. Yes! I remember listening to your tracks last night. They're so awesome and 8-bit. Full screen. Look at that. That's some nice hair. Some hair animation. Good job, man, on this music, art, and everything. I like your overworld. Oh, cool. Choo-choo-choo! Revenge and survival. Shoot death. Whoa, that was a cool effect. Oh, nice. I love it, man. Excellent execution. Excellent execution of the 8-bit style, man. So true. Love it, man. Nice. Oh, whoa. Oh, cool. Thanks. Let me check these out. for later. Okay, cool. Simplex. Simplex noise. Thank you. Thank you. I'll check that out. This is map generation using noise. Oh, but also using Simplex. Cool. I gotta check out Simplex because I'm only familiar with Perlin so far. Nice, cool, man. Are you doing a cool like Nestbox? Oh man, I'm jealous. So jealous. Yeah. Awesome. Cool, dude. Who are you using to print your boxes and stuff? Yeah, definitely get a press kit. Nice. Yeah, cool, man, for sure. Fulgar. Oh, cool. Good. Are you finding the press actually uses your press kit page and stuff? I found when I finally put up a press kit page, the press finally started writing me. I was like, whoa, I didn't know. I just had to do that. Ding, ding. Yeah, dude, I love your music, man. The music's in my head now. In my head. Distribute, yeah, that's a good one too, right? Yeah, right. Ah, uh-huh. Cool. 255 divided by 3 is what? 85? Cool. Oh, Zelda 2? Whoa. Nice, man. And Gargoyle Quest, for sure. I see that. Yeah. Gargoyle Quest, right? Classic. Gargoyle Quest, man. That was such a great one. Thanks for reminding me. Oh, wait. This is going to be R. 85, 160, 170. 170. If R is less than 85, then we do K-tile sky. Otherwise, we do K-tile rock. Because this is going to like randomize whether it uses sky tiles, rock tiles, or water tiles for this connector pattern. What's wrong with this? What is wrong with you? Oh. There we go. Yeah. Yeah, man, I can't wait to see your game come out because I can't wait to check it all out. Play it, and especially check out your music and stuff. I love some good 8-bit music, and that's some awesome 8-bit music for sure. Good job on that. Okay, so we got some sky tiles here. I gotta get out of this room to get unlocked. Let's kill this guy with a bomb. Beep, beep. Ah! This room is chaos. Not even Rambo could take that. It's a good question. I guess one advantage I can think of, Tobor, is that Press kit people are used to. So the press are used to a layout like press kit. So they're going to find your stuff pretty easily, you know? Thank you. Appreciate it. Okay. Okay, let's give the player a bunch of initial health so we can rock this room. And then play around with the dungeon a little more and see for some other rooms that need some work. Oh, you know what? I'm going to start doing some lights, some different lights. That was my plan for today. Do this little background sky. Oh, and I want to automatically set the background sky. That's important. Chaos! God, I love this. You keep on killing these guys, and they're coming back more and more. Why do they have so many hit points? Oh, I'm almost dead. Get that health. Get the health, dude. Oh! They're only going down. 99. Oh! Dude, there should be like a mini boss fight like this, because that was epic. Yeah, Volgar for sure. Sorry, man. I know what you mean. I remember those days. The bleaching hoarders in the room next to me as well. Oh, okay. I was just wondering. I thought you were going to do like a professional run and print off your boxes and stuff. That would be cool. Did you have one of those for your Kickstarter? Did you like sell box versions or something? Vlad, do you have a game you're working on? What's up, Betavel? Some different lights. I want to draw some different lights. I'm going to draw them right now. Oh, I forgot about the automatic sky. Let's do the automatic sky first. Oh, well, if you start to have something, boy, I would love to check it out. There's a lot of us here on the stream that have our own games and stuff that we're working on. Yeah, I saw a Kickstarter recently that just did a Super Nintendo. They actually did a Super Nintendo game, and their Kickstarter did really well. So they're making a Super Nintendo game right now that's actually a Super Nintendo cartridge. And their Kickstarter did awesome. Yeah. Oh, right, cool. Yes, I totally agree. That's kind of why mine was the same. So I didn't really do too many physical. I only did one physical reward, and that's a poster, which is really easy to print. Whoa, rad. That's cool, Vlad. Wow, nice. Thanks, Platformer Labs. So, automatic sky. Start with dungeon, so it doesn't do a background style. So, okay, background style, none. And then area patterns. I guess I could do it right here. But Bool has sky equals false. So if I run it now, it should not have any kind of background. Yeah, show us, Vlad. Show us. We want to see. All right, cool. So it's just a black sky right now, and we'll fix it by if has sky. If we have a sky tile, set as sky. It's probably a better way to do this, but I'm just doing it here in this method for now. If has sky and background style, I think it was just BG style. BG style equals K background none, then BG style equals K background sky one plus area pause dot Z minus one. Which it's not gonna like because it went to, you just static cast it, static cast to a background style. There we go. Cool. Is there any copyrighted music in this? I gotta mute it first just in case. Enable Oriris.
So we're hoping to be pleased.
Nice. Cool, good for you guys. Nice, so it's all voice activated. Oh, does it? Whoa. So is it following his eyes? For that mouse cursor thing? That's pretty awesome. Or is it following his face or head? Oh, his head gestures. Oh, okay. Wow, good job, lad. What an interesting company to be working with or for. That's awesome. Oh, it's all you? Is this you right here?
Challenge. Aside from recognition from the mobile giant.
Oh, you're doing the code? Nice.
Which is why I'm super excited to announce we've decided to donate all funds raised on Indiegogo, past, present, and future, towards devices that will go to people in need.
Cool.
So, since we've secured funding, we can fulfill on.
Nice. Man, it's so cool what technology is starting to do. Ah, right on, man. Right on. Yeah. Touch is, I love that. Yeah, touch is overrated. Definitely a sweet slogan. Wow, nice. Cool. You guys got a vision and everything. Right. Me too. I'm making a game about psychedelics over here. Let's see if this even worked. All right, cool. Yeah, it added a nice sky background. We got it. Psychedelic time. Okay, so I want to make sure that when I go up to this other level, or this other screen up here, it doesn't have a background. I can't even tell if it does or not. Thanks. Yeah, there you go. There you go. Right, Light of Thief, right. See, Tobor, we're doing something good for the world. We're making enjoyment. Just one bit of joy, one tiny moment of joy, elevates the entire universe just a little bit, which means we have infinite value because the universe wouldn't be the same without us. All of us, everything we're doing, everybody, no matter what you're doing. Yeah, I agree. This is directly helping the world. Directly helping. Okay, I'm kind of getting bugged by this guy he's getting stuck in the wall right there. So I'm going to fix him up right now. No, should I? Yeah, I guess I'll fix him really quick. It shouldn't be that hard to fix him. Because I know that it's all in where it's placing him, so there's this function here where it places an enemy. It's called get evenly spaced position, I believe. Right. Yeah, we're all benefiting each other. Okay, I gotta figure out what's up with this guy. I'm gonna make sure that it's even doing here. This is the where I'll break it. Break it, break it, break it, break. Oh, I know, right? Ah, oh, I bet that's such a cool moment. All right, Light of Thief, good night, man. Pleasant dreams. This one, what? Why aren't you showing me the vector? What's your vector, Victor? Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, Vlad's project is reminding us all of how lucky we all are, right? It's amazing. I'm a lucky man. I'm lucky I'm still alive. 35 years on this planet, and I'm not dead. Just that is awesome. Okay, what's up? It's not the first, not the second guy, not the third guy. Must be the fourth guy. Oh, it's not the fourth guy? Right. Is anybody expecting this? No. But it's awesome. Fourth guy? Tell me it's the fifth guy. Oh, there it is. This guy right here. Why are you the fifth guy? Oh, wait. Is it this one? Yeah, it was the fifth guy. Wait, what the heck? Why is it putting so many enemies? Oh, this is the grass. Okay, so I gotta break this when it's looking for. Oh. Get evenly. What is wrong with you? Function work better. Yeah, I have. Yep, my last game was called Hero Bash. It was a multiplayer MOBA for iOS. I did it with my friend. He did all the art and the design of the game, and I did all the programming and the sound. So this game, Songbringer, is my first project solo, making everything myself, including the art. This is our game. It's a real-time multiplayer MOBA. But it never did that well, because we didn't really know how to market games. And so I didn't do too well with that. But now Songbringer is going really well. Songbringer, I finally kind of learned how to market. So that's good. Yeah, also, yeah, I worked on The Seventh Guest. I didn't actually work on The Seventh Guest, but I worked for the company that made The Seventh Guest. So yeah, Trilobite. Trilobite was a company where from my hometown in Oregon, and they made The Seventh Guest and The 11th Hour, and I interned there for a few months. So that was way back in the day. That was like 1998. But yeah, that's the only famous company I've ever worked for. Everything else has just been kind of just humble stuff. Humble projects here and there. Yeah, right? They were saying The Seventh Guest actually sold CD-ROMs. Yeah. It was an amazing game. And the guy behind all that, his name is Graham Devine, and he's definitely still one of my heroes to this day. He's a really cool guy. He was cool to work with. Very unique. He's so eccentric. He's a very eccentric guy. But incredibly intelligent, incredibly gifted, and incredibly insightful and stuff. So Graham Devine, very cool guy. I think he still works with Valve. I think last I checked, he works at Valve. What's up? Welcome to the stream. Potato Power. Potato Power. That's right. Stick a fork in my potato. Connect them with some wire. And I got some power. Potato Power. Create grass. Oh, here it is. Okay, this is where it creates an AI. And it's creating an evenly spaced position. It's got all these faux positions. Filter static. Filter water. Oh, because it might be because it's using tile size. Let's try a bigger tile size. Let's see if that fixes this algorithm. Tile size dot width times. Tile size dot height times. Okay, if this worked, then this guy's not gonna be stuck on the wall. Oh, he's still stuck. He's dancing it out up there. Well, I guess we could try it higher. This is probably not the problem. It might be the mask. What's this extra number here? Oh, now even more guys are stuck. Okay, so it's not this. Closeness factor. What's a persistence issue? What's it about? What's your issue? I know what you mean, though. This game's procedural too, and it can be tricky. Sometimes you're like, what the hell? What the hell is going on right here? Like right now, I'm like, why the hell is this guy being put up there? First of all, he's being put in the wall, and second of all, this other algorithm is not working to put him off of the wall. Okay, I want to step into this algorithm because that'll help. Yeah, I totally remember that. Yeah, I did fix that guy. I know you guys were like, it's a feature, leave him. But it kept bugging me. I just fixed it anyways. But now we've got this little issue, so I'm going to step in. That's probably the best thing to do here is just like step into the algorithm and figure it out. So I'm going to set a breakpoint, make it conditional on name equals drop and I equals, I don't know, I'm not sure which I it is, so it's Oh. Cool. Interesting approach. It's cool to see how different people's minds create things, you know? Especially when it comes to procedurally generating worlds and stuff. Because there's so many different ways you can go. You can create it this way, you can create it that way. And, you know, they're all valid ways of doing it, but they're all so different. All right, Ark. Good night, Ark. Okay, so I'm going to check. Okay, so not that guy. Wait a second. Create AI. This should be passing in a different index each time. Much love. I is 0. I is 1. Okay, why wasn't it? I guess that breakpoint wasn't working right. Oh well. P starts with some values. Oh no, it doesn't. Oh, cool, man. Nice. You threw in what time of day and year? That's rad. Cool. Nice. That's similar to the Binding of Isaac approach, I think. They'd had like a whole bunch of rooms they could use and they randomized them. But yeah, I mean, that's a pretty smart way to do it because you're blending both bespoke environments. You know, you got these bespoke, beautiful. You can design them just how you want them, and then you randomize how they work together. That's a cool way of doing it. Yeah, Spelunky too, totally. Yeah, I read, Tom Coxon. So if anybody's interested in procedural algorithms, I'm always pointing people at Tom Coxon's MetaZelda. And Tom Coxon learned from Spelunky. So Spelunky actually published a lot of their algorithms as well. And then kind of Tom Coxon did it with his game is called Lena's Inception, and it's a sort of Game Boy Zelda style game, but it's all procedurally generated. So he talks about different forms of procedural generation. I think it's here in this article. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure which one of these articles it is, but if you go to this page, this is a really rad page. Yeah, and can't you like blow up the whole walls and everything everywhere you go in Spelunky? Yeah. Oh, is it that one? Yeah, lock and key puzzle. That's a great one. That's a great article. That's where I based my whole dungeon generator on that algorithm, and mine's a little bit different because it doesn't make any distinction between keys and switches. And I got some really cool ideas for switches too. I'm gonna do some. It's not gonna be like a typical switch where you step on a switch and something happens. It's gonna be like you solve a puzzle, and that technically is a switch. Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah, Spelunky. Spelunky looks fun. Oh, no, it's not true, Vlad. For me, this is kind of a cool hangout session, and also I get to, it's really great for me because I get to get direct feedback from you guys. You know, like I'm making this little feature, and then you guys are like, oh, you should do that or that or that. And it's been incredibly helpful. This whole project wouldn't be the same without the live stream and you guys and all your suggestions and also all your giving on the Kickstarter. So that's enabled me to keep on making this game full time, which I'm eternally grateful for. So all I wanted to do was step into the algorithm once it makes the one guy who's getting stuck. Cool, nice. Yeah. I think it's a cool way to do it because you're blending two different, you're using procedurally generated in the sense that you're randomly organizing, but you're also using bespoke environments, and that's nice. Minesweeper sequence? Minesweeper. Classic. Oh man, classic. How many times did I play Minesweeper as a kid? Oh, it might be this guy, the second guy. Oh, or this guy. What index was this? Three? Yeah, that was it. Mike, what you mean, Mike? Stay the whole time? Really? Don't you do you have I forget how it works. Like, do you once you win Minesweeper? Oh yeah, it's just one level at a time, yeah. I've beat it, but only on the small maps, you know. Once you get to the big maps, dude, Minesweeper is hard. Minesweeper the movie? Nuh-uh. What? Minesweeper the movie?
You're here because you're the best of the best. You come to me as beginner. When I'm done with you, you'll be experts. You are here to sweep my floor.
I hear he finished this one in like 2 seconds.
I'm gonna beat all his records.
What's his problem?
His dad died in the minefield.
Each time you dig, you'll find the number. That number will tell you exactly how many mines are adjacent to your square.
This
Why is he here teaching us?
Yeah, it's really easy.
Yeah, my grandma does it all the time.
Find a
grandma
one on
does
a corner.
It all the time.
It's a mine! Three on a wall, they're all mine!
Wolfsky, what's up, Wolfsky? Welcome
Nate.
Back.
And God help us all. I can see his face.
Dude, I gotta check this out later. I wanna actually watch this. This looks great. Nice. God, you know, I'm getting tired of debugging right now. I kinda wanna make some art. Yeah, I'm making art. Screw this. This guy can start in the wall. I want to draw these cool lights. I want to do some new lights that are not fire. They're more sci-fi. So yeah, dude. Start in the wall. All you want, man. Oh, look. He's stuck still. Oi, oi, oi. Oi. Yeah. Thanks for making your sprites, man. Yeah, what I want to do today is something totally different. It's for lights. It's a little bit different than an enemy and all that. If it's an ape, God help us all. Yeah, totally right, right? I'm like, dude, I've coded all week. I don't want to code anymore. So I want to do something that's of like a floating light thing. It's going to be sci-fi, and it's going to have this super cool glow, and it's going to be about the same size as the pulverizer foes. So similar in size to this guy, but a little taller. Evil deeds. What? Oh, my art pen. I missed you, buddy. This week of code has separated us, but now we are back together. Mi hermano perdido largo. Woo! Art pen! Okay, so it's going to be similar to this. This is 52 by 52. Let's do another one. 52 by 52. And what am I thinking? What am I thinking? This is sort of like I'm thinking of sort of like a lantern shape with like, I guess we're going to, I'll start with gray. I'm not sure what color to make this right now. Woo, look at this. It's a perfect square. I'm such a good artist. No, Adavel, I don't really speak Spanish. I do. I learned it in high school and stuff. So it's sort of like this, like a this type shape. And if this were like3D, it would be like this. Sí. No hablo español. That's a funny thing to say, right? I don't speak Spanish. But you say it in Spanish. I know, right? I totally should be, Vlad. L'chaim! I think that's all I know. Shekel! I have been to Israel. I've been there. I've been to, like, Jerusalem. I went to Akko. I went to Lake Kinneret. This is going to be a living entity. So we're going to call this guy. I don't know. He's like Sci-Fi Light. So we'll do Sci Light. No hablo español. Hablo español un poquito. Yes, please, give me some lessons. I'd love that. Teach me something right now. What can I learn that's simple? Lampatron 9000, good name. Okay, I'm going to name it Lampatron 9000. Good call, Potato Power. This is being renamed as we speak to Lampatron 9000. Ooh, 9009? Dude, 9009 is even cooler. Lampatron 9009. Nine numbers, even more. Cool. All right, so I want this guy to glow sort of like a... Oh, I know what I want. I want some red juice inside this thing. And so when you can actually hurt it, and when you hurt this thing, all of its juice falls out, and like you bust it open and stuff. That's over 9,000. Say what you want, and I will translate it. I have a Lampatron 9,000 for you, Mr. Noseworth. Mr. Noseworth. Okay, all of this is kind of... Well, let's do a little bit of shading on this, and then I'll put it in the game. So I like to put things in the game as fast as possible, because quite often what I'm drawing doesn't look the same once I put it in the game. So it's... Oops, I drew that on the wrong layer. So it's really good to put things in the game, basically. So I'm just doing a rough draft like outline of this thing first, and then it'll be put into game time as fast as possible. Lampatron 9009, get yours! Order before they're all gone! You don't understand? I don't even know what to say that I want translated. Okay, there it is. Lampatron 9009. Let's see what it looks like. Just floating. We'll put one of these in the world. Ah. Gracias. Oh, wait. You said bonita. Nice one. You got me. I know what that means. You wanted... You want to drink a coffee with me? Oh, do no. Do you want to drink a coffee with me? My plan so far is to attempt to translate Songbringer into Spanish myself, and then have some Spanish-speaking friends actually do it. Actually, make sure that it all translated well. Yeah, it's gonna be in Italian, thanks to Alex Pita, and I have funky pits. It's true. It's true. Oh, today they're not so bad. Wow. It's probably because I got my towel. It's towel day, everybody. If you forgot. LK. What is tray? Try? I don't know what this one means. La canción. Canción. I don't know what this means. El que lleva la canción. What am I saying? I don't even know. Hebrew? Cool. That would be awesome. Yeah, thanks. Thanks, Alessandro. Thanks. Alessandro offered to translate Songbringer months ago. And so, thanks to Alessandro. I've been putting that word out that it's going to be in Italian for sure. We got to get this thing saved and put in the game right now. It's been too many seconds. Lampatron 9009. Frame zero. Oh. Isn't that weird? Some things you just can't quite translate. Alright, so I'm going to do a tile. Nope, I think I'm just going to do a regular, I'll throw an entity into the world. I'm pretty much everywhere. Really? Oh, wow, I wish I could get in your head right now and understand why it sounds that way in Hebrew. Is it similar to other words or something? That's funny. Okay, so yeah, in area, I'm going to do one of these new kind of items. Okay, let's make a property list for it. Similar to a pulverizer. Lampatron 9009. Oh, right. Okay, so it has no behavior, at least not yet. It does have health, so it has one hit point, and if you kill it, it will break open. It has no move component, does have a collision component. Which is 12 by 8? 12 by, yeah, 12 by 8 is probably going to be pretty good. Cannot be knocked back. It doesn't need any kind of pathfinding. Sounds, for now, it has no sounds. Oh, wait. Actually, we should give it a hurt sound. And release. Well, release will be the hurt sound. All right. Yeah, that's where I wish I could be inside your head for a second and understand why. Weird science. Weird science. That was a good movie and a good song. All right. All it needs is an idle animation. And this is Lampatron 9009% D. And I think all I gotta do is create a being. Lampatron. If area pause dot z is greater than 0, and flags and k flag locked. So I know this room is locked, and so that's why we're gonna just do one of these guys just in this locked room for now. Yeah, Vlad, I do. Yep. So check it out. Here's the tracks on SoundCloud that I've written so far for Songbringer. They don't play all the time, so when I'm playing the game and it's not playing any music, it's because I don't want music to play the whole time. Oh, yeah, Pale Ale, already got it. Nice, yeah. That's what I'm just going to post it too. Double it up. Hey, welcome to the stream, Juno. So, but that way, Vlad, you can actually hear it with bass. So if you're, besides, if I were to play it on my laptop speakers, it would, you're just hearing it record from my actual laptop, so it wouldn't sound, you wouldn't hear any bass. Entities that push back, this create being. The being we are creating is a Lampatron. Lampatron 9009. Position right in the middle. Area size dot width times a half. Area size dot height times a half. Alive. I guess it's alive, yeah. Intelligence. Let's make it super intelligent, even though it doesn't really do anything. Yeah, so that's what it'll be like. It's going to be kind of like Sword and Sorcery, and how Sword and Sorcery played its music only once. Like, you only heard one song once during the whole game, and that's how this game's going to work, too. So it'll have lots of ambiance. But tracks, music tracks, only play once. Okay, so this is not going to have any glow or any light emitting from it, but I want to see if it even puts it on the screen. Oh, cool. Yeah, it's there. Oh, I got hurt by it? That's funny. So we gotta change its profile so it's not gonna hurt me. So its category is neutral. It collides with none for when it moves. It's got a size of 12 by 8 and it does 0 damage. Nice, man. No, Doc, I've never really used code folding much. Do you? Do you use it? And does it work for you? Like, I've never really have. Nice, Juno. Very happy sound. 1 minute, huh? It reminds me of like Final Fantasy's some of Final Fantasy's tracks where you played like the Dodo Bird version. It's really happy and playful. What's up, Ethan? Oh, cool. Nice. This is a very nice transition. There we go. Now I'm not colliding with this guy. Okay, let's give it some light and make it glow. Nice. Yeah, good job. Man, I'm starting to get hungry. I'm starting to run out of steam already. What? Okay, so I gotta give this some light, some glow. Yeah. I've never really used it. You know, I guess it would make sense if I had some. I do have a lot of long functions, you know, everywhere. But I don't know. I can't see myself really. Starting to use it. All right, so we need some light and some glow. Already got a create light function. Or is it create fire? Yeah, create fire. Here it is. This is where I got this oval gradient thing. It's creating a whole entity for it, for this. Lampatron. Yeah, I guess I wanted to cast shadows. Here, set up a position for it. Hey, welcome to the stream, Pema. Yeah, I hear you. It is kind of finicky, right? It's such a tiny little bar they've got for you to do it. Whoops. See, in there, I did it, and I'm like, where the hell did my code go? Nice. Hey, what's up, Arcane? Welcome to the stream. Welcome back. Once again, welcome back. I'm kind of running out of stream. I think I'm gonna stop the stream in about 5 or 10 minutes. Actually, I'm getting hungry as hell. Stomach's growling. Light offset 0, 15. That's probably would do 15 or so. It's creating a light component. Light scale equals 0.5 maybe. Flags. Okay, so flags. Flags equals 0. Oh, yeah, I'm sure, right? Wow. Yeah, I bet folding is, like, necessary in that case. So you're saying Vim has code folding? Oh, flags. We do want to name just that F. Ugh. So this light's going to flicker. Vim has everything. Yeah, I've heard. I keep hearing more and more about how awesome Vim is. I kind of want to learn. I'm tired of my hands getting all messed up. Okay, there. Now it's kind of emitting a little bit of light. And if I get over to a different part of the screen, yeah, it's got a tiny little glow for it, too. The offset's a little high and the color is wrong. So we set that there. Wow, cool. I never knew that. Good for Vim. All right, good night, Alex Pita. Pleasant dreams. All right, Ethan, I'm just working on some code today and some new art for this little lamp thing. I'm working on a lamp right now. So I've got a background done here with sky tiles, so you can actually see through the ground now. And now I'm working on a little light that will go, that'll be sort of sci-fi. So right now it's flickering and it's not. That's the first thing I should change, actually, is like, I'm working on this light right here. Basically, this is going to be a nice bright light thing. And you're going to be able to destroy this light. All right, see you tomorrow. Later. Color is really going to matter here. So this color, what hue is this? Hue 9. Red 147. Man, I keep up. Whoops. I just opened Firefox instead of calculator. 147 divided by 255 is 85.5. Oh, wow. Yeah, sounds like it. Wow. Nice, Ethan. Good job. Oh, this is wrong. What's the last number? The winning number is 36. 141. So now it should be the right color and it won't be flickering. Whoa, cool. That color is crazy. Super crazy. It's like it's sucking up the light around it almost. Wow, that's awesome. Let me do a light scale of 1, actually. Whoa. This is like some red light districts over here. Okay, I want it to fade in and out. render sprite run action. Yeah, totally. He's kind of a bloody light at this point. Scale by create. Whoa, dude. Why are you giving me all that? Scale by create. Over the course of, I think a whole 2 seconds actually, we'll scale it by 1.1. And then over the next 2 seconds, we do the inverse to bring it back. So that should make it pulsate, sort of. Why is it sucking up the light around it? It's not working. Why is it not pulsating? That sounds good. God, it's making me even hungrier. Yeah, I gotta stop the stream soon. Five more minutes. So it's 6:11. I'm going to stop the stream. Get myself some lunch. I'm about to lunch it. It's towel day. Everybody got their towels? Honor of Douglas Adams. Oh, it was because of the opacity. Whoa, that's crazy. Okay, so it's an oval. Let's play with making it really tall all of a sudden, and then okay, so it's too bright. Let's set the opacity down a bit. Let's set it at half to start with. We gotta make this lamp thing float. That'll help too. I think this anchor point might be a little off. Oh, never mind. That was really helping it, actually. Wow. Okay, so that anchor point stays. And light offset, I think, should be less. So maybe 5 on the light offset. Probably gonna make this a different color. Maybe I should make it procedural based on the level color. Let's try the level color. That's gonna be color.r. GB. Oh, wow. It's like an icy glow now. All right, well, that's it for today's live stream. I gotta get some food, and after that, I'm gonna keep on working on this some more. So this is still not quite what I was imagining for this little thing here. First of all, I want it to float in the air, so it'll have like a floating animation. Second of all, I'm gonna totally redraw it and make it look cooler. It sort of like looks too icy right now. Then I'm gonna play around with the light color and sort of make it look more like a piece of technology rather than like a floating lantern like it is right now. So, but yeah, I'll play around with that, and I'll play around with some more tiles for the level too. So, playing around with these sky tiles, so more of the level will have like sky showing through it and stuff. So yeah, that's it for today's stream, you guys. Cool, nice. I will, nice. Oh yeah, thank you all, guys. Thank you so much. Cheers. Hope you all have a great day. Thanks for your suggestions and stuff too, and for all the cool links and stuff. So, catch you guys next time.